गुड आफ्टरनून। वेलकम बैक अगेन। नाउ वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट द दलित मूवमेंट, दलित मूवमेंट्स इन इंडिया। ओके, इन दिस पेपर वी हैव 5 मॉड्यूल्स। We'll see today the first concept in our first module about Dalit movements. You are well aware that Dalit a community. Which outside the varnas, from our ancient period, India has a chaturvarna system. Among the chaturvarna, we have only the 4 varnas, like Brahmin, क्षेत्रीय, वैश्य एंड शूद्र। दलित इज ए लोअर क्लास, ए अनटचेबल, अंतज, चंडाला, विच इज आउटसाइड ऑफ दिस चतुर्वर्ण सिस्टम। Okay, so Dalits are never in the part of the Chaturvarna. Okay, it's a outside caste. So in ancient period we call it as the outcaste, Antajas. And for the Dalit, various terms used. Okay, so in Constitution of India, during the frame of 1935 Act, there is a certain provisions given to Dalits at that time. So when the using the Dalit in a constitutional framework, they use a term called the scheduled caste for all the Dalit, or a well known term at that time is Aryan. Okay, to bring a common term, scheduled caste used for the Dalit. Okay, so scheduled caste is a common term which are using in our Constitution of India, according to Government of India under Presidential Order 1950. Then onwards, for official usages, we are using a term called the scheduled caste. So these scheduled castes are number of names, various names in all over Indian territories. Okay, you are aware that the scheduled caste population is in India, we find nearly a 15% of the total Indian population. And Indian caste constitution provided a 15% of reservation to these scheduled caste people in various fields. So this scheduled caste, before using of the scheduled caste, different terms used among them is the Dalit, Harijan, likewise. Apart from these, there are unknown terms also used since our initial days, like Dasa. Dasa is a term which is used in Rigvedic culture. You find the term Dasa in the text Rigveda. The term Dasa is several times repeated in Rigveda also. But the Dasa is not a part in the Chaturvarna system at that time. So according to the Purushottama theory of Rigveda, we don't find Dasa in the Chaturvarna. We find only the four Varnas. So apart from the Dasa, Dasyus also used. Later, Asuras a term used. And Antajas also the term used. And Avarnas, Nishadas, Chandala, Mlecha, Panchamas, all these are certain terms which used for the Dalit. Okay, so what the term is, what the term use? Finally, the main occupation of these groups are, they have to serve for the Chaturvarna. They also serve to Sudras, not only a Brahmin, Kshatriya, Vaishya, but also they have to serve the Sudras also. The work of Sudra is, the Sudras have to work above three Varnas. But these Dalits have to serve for the four Varnas also. Okay, it's the main occupation. But later, these Dalits followed different occupations based on the time immemorial. Okay, when you see the different words or different terms which are used for these Dalits in various states in India, these Dalits were found in various parts of India, in north and southern, east and west. In only northeastern parts, you find very little, but in other parts, there is a kind big amount or the big population you find. For this Dalit, there are various names, various groups. When you see, for example, in Telangana or Andhra Pradesh, you find nearly 56 sub-communities in the Dalit. 56, like Mala, Madiga, Dakkali, Relli, Sindhu, Dasa, Dasu. Likewise, you find 56 communities you find. Likewise, many names also you find in other states also. Like you take Tamil Nadu. Tamil Nadu you find the Parayas, Pallas, Chekliyas. These are various communities in comes under Dalit. When you see in the Kerala, Kerala Pulayas, Cherumans, Yezuas, and many other communities in Kerala. When you see in Karnataka, Holeyas, Idigas are certain terms used for Dalits. When you see in northern states like Punjab and Haryana, you have a terms called Valmikis, Bangis, they use. And in Maharashtra, Mahars, Mangas, Mochis, and certain times terms they use. In Uttar Pradesh, Chamar is an important term used for Dalit. So these are various terms used for Dalit. Number of states you find various sub-communities among the scheduled caste which are comes under a Dalit. So these are various terms used for the Dalit. To give a common name, Mahatma Gandhi tried some best to give certain equal opportunity to the Dalits to other communities which are in higher level in this fourfold structure. So Mahatma Gandhi used a term Harijan, and he also explained about the term, why he used the particular term. Among the term Harijan, Hari means divine or a god. Jan is a people. Okay, the combination of term Harijan implied that Dalits are a people of God. But then the name of Dalit as Harijan did not cultivate any positive attitude towards the Dalit. Just he given only the name. And he tried a lot to give certain importance to this lower class. But his efforts were later became a vain. But after the efforts of Gandhiji, it prolonged for 10 years like that, and then the effort of giving certain importance to Dalits were went in a vain. Because no other no support from the leaders of Indian National Congress or from the Indian society has taken place. That's why gradually the Mahatma Gandhi also which leave that concept. Okay, so when you see the term Dalit, particularly Dalit is a term which is a Marathi term, literally means ground or a broken piece. Okay, so Dalit, it is a combination of Dal. Dal means it's a ground or a broken two pieces. Okay, so it was a Marathi term, it is commonly used by a political party in Maharashtra called as a Dalit Panthers and Republic Party of India. So this is a term which was mainly popularized by the Dalit Panthers, and later which is commonly used by Republic Party of India. Okay, so Dalit not only belongs to a lower caste category, but also a outcast or a untouchable senior, because the upper class are not accept anything from this lower class. Okay, so as a result, these Dalit have to seeking the government support to have certain equality among the other people. Other people in the sense, the upper classes. So it was impossible up to the Indian independence. After getting of Indian independence, we prepared Constitution of India. According to the Constitution of India, provided certain protection programs or protection rights to these Dalits in the various fields. So still these are continuing. Okay, so when you see about a certain political mobilization of the Dalit, up to 1920, we don't find any certain mobilization among the Dalit by any a leader or a political personality. But it is a initial step taken by a great personality, is nothing but the Jyoti Phule. So due to the efforts of Mahatma Jyotiba Phule, certain privileges they got, because according to the Phule's effort, many other personalities followed the same. Among them, Dr. B.R. Ambedkar was a pioneer among the Dalit rights. According to his efforts, many privileges has provided many political opportunities and social equality, economical freedom they got. So according to his efforts, only Dalits got a certain prestigious level in the Indian society. So the Dalits got certain importance with the efforts of Mahatma Phule and also Dr. B.R. Ambedkar. After B.R. Ambedkar, certain political parties has continued, among them Dalit Panthers in Maharashtra and Republic Party of India. Both are the two important parties which carried the fighting for their rights. Later, Bahujan Samaj Party, which has done a great effort to fight for the Dalit rights. Okay, so it is started with Ambedkar from 1930 onwards. He want to fight for the Dalit rights with a platform. Okay, so he want to start a platform. So in 1942, he formed All India Scheduled Caste Federation. And before, earlier, it is a organization in the form of a party called as Indian Labour Party. Indian Labour Party also effort of Dr. B.R. Ambedkar. up to 1942. After 1942, in the place of Indian Labour Party, he established All India Scheduled Caste Federation to mobilize the lower section of Indian society. That's nothing but a Dalit. He sought to use this organization to appeal the wider awareness, including the economical freedom also. And you want to aware the industrial workers and also agricultural laborers also. So agricultural workers and laborers from the Dalit communities. Okay, so after the foundation of All India Scheduled Caste Federation, he started certain efforts and he started awaring the Dalits all over India, and gradually he also became a well-known person and pioneer. Many of Dalit leaders in all over Indian territories are following his guidelines and instructions, and they also started certain branch movements in various places, and certain political support and also economical support also he gained from various political sources. By this way, between 1946 and 1951, in both the general elections, he participated and he contested. Okay, so he contested in both elections, but we don't find any particular result. But in 1956, one or two persons elected from the Dalit community, and after 1956, All India Scheduled Caste Federation was dissolved and Republic Party of India is formed. Okay, so Republic Party of India formed in 1957. Okay, so after 1957 up to 1964 and 65, Republic Party of India, which represented these Dalits in the political bodies, particularly in lower and upper houses. Okay, so after Republic Party of India, Dalit Panthers from Bombay, they are started contesting from 1972 onwards.